Hello, friends. I'm Bob Richards with another Wheaties Sports Federation special program on fitness in America. The sport, gymnastics. The athletes, all-American gymnasts. Newt Loken, as a past president of the National Association of Gymnastic Coaches, and as a coach of one of the great gymnastic teams at the University of Michigan, can you tell us this? When there's no basket to make, no touchdown to score, no finish line to cross, why are gymnastic events so exciting?
Well, from the individual competitor's point of view, Bob, no other sport offers quite the same challenge to perfect coordination and fitness. A gymnast takes the same God-given physical structure that most of us are provided with. He develops it to raise a sharp edge, disciplines it with a keen sense of balance and coordination, and then he submits it to a precise evaluation in which the slightest flaw can be the difference between success and failure.
Well, what about the spectator, Newt? What is his thrill in watching gymnastics?
Well, we feel the same as in other sports, Bob. But he must adjust his sense of values to measure the abilities of one athlete at a time and to evaluate the fine points of this person's routine in terms of body development, coordination, timing, rhythm, and balance.
Thanks a lot, Newt. That's important. For while the spectator seldom has an opportunity to learn and put into practice the skills he sees on a football field, a basketball court, a baseball diamond, what he can learn from the gymnast and put to work in his daily life is of immeasurable value. Keep that in mind now as you witness the final competition of the 1959 National Collegiate Athletic Association Gymnastics Meet held recently in Berkeley, California. These are the competitors representing colleges and universities from every part of the country in the meet. The selection committee, all past presidents of the National Association of Gymnastic Coaches, checked the last-minute details on the final competition in 9 separate events. And here is the best all-around gymnast in the competition. Penn State's Armanda Vega, a 22-year-old senior from Los Angeles, coached by Gene Whetstone, putting on the most brilliant performance of his career. Keep in mind as you watch this young man glide smoothly from one exercise to another in this routine, that as its name implies, this is still ring competition. The rings are supposed to remain stationary throughout the exhibition. Notice the perfect muscle coordination and control. Right now, he's placing his body into the form of a cross in different positions, one of the most difficult of all gymnastic maneuvers because of the absolute precision and body control. You'd think his strength was gone by now, but he's just beginning, and the next one's tougher still, and the next one's certainly no less difficult. From an L position into a handstand, and he's beginning to show the strain ever so slightly. He's been up there for some time now, but it's not quite over. He still must come down, and even that maneuver counts in his final score. And judges rate him 96, 95, and 93 out of a possible one. Here's All-American rope climbing champion Don Littlewood of Penn State, up 20 feet of rope in 3.5 seconds. You'll see 6 other All-American gymnasts in action in the next reports in this series. In the first report in this series, you saw University of Michigan gymnastics coach Newt Loken, and heard him say that no other sport demands quite as much from the individual competitor in total fitness as does gymnastics. And you saw All-American Armanda Vega and Don Littlewood win their championships in rope climbing, still rings, and the parallel bar competition. Those were 3 of the 9 events in the All-American that one of the judges scored him 100 out of 100 points, the highest score of the entire meet in Berkeley this year. This is All-American Dave Delaney of Penn State, a 21-year-old senior from the state of Pennsylvania. In tumbling competition, each man makes 4 trips across the mat, actually throwing his body into carefully coordinated exercises which strain every muscle. There's no artificial momentum, just sheer strength and agility. Movie star Joe E. Brown, honorary member of the selection committee, was especially pleased to award this medal. Gymnastics was one of the skills which helped launch his career. This is the free exercise event. Complicated maneuvers which combine the skills of the all-around gymnast with the form and grace of the ballet. The champion is All-American Don Tonre, a 22-year-old senior at the University of Illinois, coached by Charlie Pond. He is not only a capable fundamentalist, but displays remarkable poise, grace, and agility throughout the routine. In this event, as in all others, the gymnasts develop their routines with the help of their coaches, but in free exercise competition, each pose must be held for about 3 seconds to give the judges time to study it for flaws. In Tonry, they found very few. Continuity of action is another guidepost for the free exercise gymnast. He must keep his routine flowing smoothly from one exercise to the next in a cohesive pattern. Only when he has assumed a pose does Tonry hesitate in his body motion, and then he comes out of it as gracefully as possible and on into the next maneuver. Contrast this with the gymnastic skills of continuous suspension, the flying rings, high bar, and trampoline, the events you'll see in our final report on gymnastics. When the 1959 Intercollegiate Gymnastic Meet was held in Berkeley, California recently, the Wheaties Sports Federation cameras were trained on the All-Americans in 9 events. In this final report of our series on fitness, as the gymnast knows it, you'll see why few skills are more demanding of the individual athlete than those which exact the perfect muscular development and mental control of the gymnast. Imagine yourself to be a 20-year-old fella named Stan Tarshis, a Michigan State junior from Tujunga, California, coached by George Zepula. You'd be, as he is, one of the finest high bar men in the world, twisting and turning over and under a steel bar 8 feet above the floor. And this would be the most exciting 30 seconds of your life. But this skill didn't come to Stan Tarshis any easier than it comes to any other All-American. Probably not as easy as some. Stan worked a long time and very hard to bring his physical and mental alertness to this degree of perfection. But that's what it takes to be an All-American. Or would you rather be this 21-year-old University of Michigan senior by the name of Ed Cole, coached by Newt Loken? Cole, the University of Michigan team captain, gets several bounces from the trampoline to start him on his way, then makes 8 trips into the air to carry out the first half of his routine. Each bounce on the trampoline must come at precisely the right split second in Cole's routine if he's to make the most of his time in the air. After a 20-second rest, Cole starts all over again with another series of 8 bounces. He starts with a full flippus, which means a double back somersault with a full twist and a back flip out of it into a double somersault out of that, finishing up after a series of flips with a Rudolph followed by a triple twister for the finish. And you're an All-American. Perhaps you'd like a truly breathtaking skill. May I suggest the flying rings? Penn State's Jay Werner, a Philadelphia 20-year-old who's a junior, isn't in this just for fun. For him, it's serious business. Hurtling through the air in an 80-degree arc and straining every muscle to maintain poised balance between those rings. The form, flawless. The execution's brilliant. Now, we can't all be as truly skilled as Jay Werner or Ed Cole or Stan Tarshis. Most of us could never be All-American gymnasts, any more than we'd be All-American football players or basketball stars or track and field athletes. But all Americans should be and could be physically fit.
Jackie Schmitz from Southern Illinois University. So I think he's the first place winner in this event. Steve Cohen from Penn State. It's a little tight. Gary Hoskins from Cal State LA. I believe this is Dan Millman from Cal. That's the way, Dan. I think this is Rusty Rock from San Fernando Valley.
It looked like Dan Millman on that ball.
I think this is Sid Rudenstein.
Yes.
And I think, that's Sid Rudenstein again. Russia to the floor was one of the first ones. This is Fred Seagram from Long Beach State College. I had no trouble with this the other day. I think this is the young man from Iowa State. Had a pretty good diameter, yes.